Valley pledged to provide lawmakers a new gambling bill by Friday that they could consider during a special session this summer. His comments came after a 90-minute meeting with House Speaker Michael Bush and members of the Baltimore City delegation at City Hall. 11 News I-Team reporter David Collins has been following the developments. He joins us live from the newsroom. David.
Well, Donna, the meeting is essential because there's still not enough votes in the House to pass a gambling bill. The city delegation is a big voting bloc and, on the record, opposed to a sixth casino. The governor and Speaker Bush assured delegation members that a mechanism can be put in place to help offset any potential loss of revenues the city would suffer because of the impact a sixth gaming site could have on Baltimore's planned casino.
I just want to say thank you all for coming. No horse trading for votes, just the facts. If a sixth casino opens in Prince George's County, what can be done to keep Baltimore from losing gambling revenues the city wants to put toward lowering the property tax rate?
Do you have provisions to make sure that the city and the Anne Arundel County are held harmless in terms of local share?
The local share is gambling revenue used to offset the impact of hosting a casino. Now on the table is a proposal to increase Baltimore City's share by 5%.
We believe we can take the money, put it into a collective pot of Prince George's, Anne Arundel, and Baltimore City, divide it up in the percentages where Anne Arundel would get its full expectation of money and Baltimore City would get its full expectation of money.
10 of the 18 members of the Baltimore City delegation were able to attend the meeting called by Mayor Stephanie Rollins-Blake. Delegation Chairman Kurt Anderson characterized the presentation as murky.
One thing my mama always told me is, get it in writing. So that's what we want to do. We want to see it in writing and take a look at, because we have to make a decision not just, for the casino operator in Baltimore City. We have to make a decision for what's best for the citizens of Baltimore City.
And there are other issues to consider, including delaying the opening of a sixth casino, the creation of a gaming commission to set tax rates. Many in the Baltimore City delegation oppose that. And shifting ownership of machines to casino operators. Then there's the Senate President Mike Miller factor. The city delegation favors table games but oppose a sixth casino. The most likely location is National Harbor. The city delegation resents the fact the Senate leaders won't move a table games only bill because the powerful Senate president has tied table games to adding a sixth location. The governor told the city delegation he'll put details of a special session gaming bill in writing by Friday. The delegation will meet Wednesday to discuss it.
Some of us heard the details of these concepts or proposals for the first time, and I do believe generally that most people felt they understood.
Any expansion of gambling will have to be approved by voters. In order to get the measure on the November ballot, a special session would have to pass a bill in time for the State Board of Elections to finalize the referendum question by August 20th. Reporting live from the newsroom, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, David.